Thank you. Right. On behalf of these two families, thank you so much for your attendance tonight. I would ask you if you would please silence your cell phones. Help us with that. If you've not done so, take the time to do so. We'll go to the Lord in prayer, and then we will begin. Our Father, we thank you for this privilege to be here. We ask for you to be glorified in everything said and done. Thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. May he be uplifted. Thank you for this young couple. Thank you for bringing these two lives together. Lord, this is a serious occasion. We want you to be glorified and honored in it. We need your strength and power tonight as much as we do at any other time in our life. May you come and be pleased to meet with us and help us, and give us that we need. May Jesus Christ be exalted. May God be glorified in everything we say and do. We'll be careful to thank you and praise you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. All rise, please. Gives this bride. Thank you. You may be seated. Well, here we are. You've dreamed about this day all these years. Look at all those people out there. They love you, and that's why they're here. What a privilege to be at this place at this time. We'll have some scriptures and some thoughts from the Word of God in this portion of the ceremony. The book of Ephesians chapter 5, verse number 25. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord, the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they too shall be one flesh. We call this holy matrimony for a reason. It's holy matrimony because marriage is ordained of God. From the very beginning, God ordained this. From the Garden of Eden, God created man, and we know from Scripture that the Lord said, it is not good that man should be alone. I still feel that way. God said, I will make an help meet for him. One man, one woman, for one life. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman, and brought her unto the man. A wife, Caleb, taken from man's side, not from his foot, to be walked beside, not to be tread upon, created as an help meet, not as a servant, taken from the side, near the heart, to ever be remembered and cherished from your heart for your lifetime. A husband to be helped, a husband to be honored, to be loved, to be followed. The two of you will have a beautiful life together, if you will keep the other first. This is Holy Communion designed by God. This is the gift of God, what we are participating in tonight. Holy matrimony because it is a picture of Christ's love for us. Christ's love does not use us and abuse us. The Lord Jesus Christ, in his love for us, he nourishes and he cherishes us. Christ's love places great emphasis on his sacrifice for us and not upon his demands from us. And that's what your love should convey to one another, your willingness to sacrifice for the other and not place demands upon them toward your own self. The love of Christ. The love of Christ is sacrificial love. Christ's love for you, Christ's love for us, it cost him everything. He gave up everything to show that he loved us, that he loves us. He willingly, willingly gave up heaven and came to earth. He willingly gave up comfort and came to a place of difficulty. That's sacrificial love. He laid down his life because he loved us. He was willing to give himself for us. This is the type of love. This is the love that is pictured for us, for the husband and the wife, to have to one another. Your love for each other must be a sacrificial love. You have come here willing to give up all others for one another for the rest of your life. Willing to give yourself totally for and to each other. This is sacrificial love. Christ's love provides everything that we need. The love of God. The love of God provides for us a new family. Provides for us a new home. That's what we're taking part of here tonight. You will have a new family and a new purpose and a new arena. The Bible says that marriage is honorable in all. What an honorable estate to come into this evening. The Lord's love was sacrificial love. His love was submissive love. He submitted himself to so much. Here is God who becomes a man. What submission, what humility, what condescension we find in the Lord Jesus Christ. He submitted himself to a level of humility that is unmatched and immeasurable. Husbands and wives are commanded in the book of Ephesians. We call this mutual submission. This is what Paul says. He says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of the Lord. Mutual submission. Christ submitted himself to die for us, and we submit ourselves to live for him. Caleb, as you submit yourself to Julie and live for her, you'll find great fulfillment and love that responds to that. And Julie, as you submit yourself and love Caleb, you will find his love to be the greatest love that you will know in this world apart from Jesus Christ. You, of course, both know the Lord as your Savior. You know God's love. You know Jesus Christ personally and intimately. What a privilege to know him, that he so sacrificed and submitted himself that we could have a relationship with God, that we could have our sins forgiven, have a home in heaven. These are wonderful things. And we get to follow in that footstep, because when we read of Christ's love for us, it's a picture. This, what you're joining here tonight, you two are joining together, and this is pictured by Christ and the church. So what a wonderful thing to be able to take part of. Christ's love is a serving love. His love is one that meets the needs of others. Your love for one another will be most fulfilled when you approach it from this viewpoint. Not what can I get out of this relationship, but what can I give? How deeply can I love my husband? How deeply can I love my wife? And when you love, you'll find that coming back to you, reciprocated. The Bible tells us in 1 John that we love him. Why? Because he first loved us. He showed that he loved us, God did, and we love him. That's just a return of love. And the greatest way to have love is to give love. The greatest way to know love is to show love. And when you love her, her love will come back. And when you love him, his love will come back to you in ways that you have only imaginations in your mind tonight of how much you love him. 25, 50 years from now, your grandpa was talking about 53 years from now, you might be here coming down the same aisle with your grandson. That's wonderful advice, and that's great aspiration. And you'll love her more then than you do today by continuing to serve her and love her. Don't ask, how much do you love me? Show this is how much I love you. Love shown becomes love received. The Lord's love is sacrificial, it's submissive, it's a serving love, and it's a sufficient love. You'll find sufficiency in the Lord Jesus Christ like you'll find nowhere else. He's all you need. He's all you need for eternity. He's all you need for peace. He's all you need for communion with God through the Lord Jesus Christ. His love is sufficient. You need not look anywhere else. And so I encourage you to find sufficiency right here. You need not look anywhere else. You're going to be given some vows in a moment of time, and you will be challenged to commit yourselves and keep yourselves only to one another. What sufficiency we find in Jesus Christ, and what sufficiency you should find in one another. All right? God so loved the world, the Bible tells us, that He gave His only begotten Son. John said in 1 John chapter 4, verse 10, "In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent His only begotten Son into the world that we might live through Him." There's a reason that we talk of these things this evening. This young couple knows the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. They want you to know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. This is a wonderful night. This is a beautiful union. This is a miraculous thing to be a part of. Something that you will always remember in your life, and something that will always be a part of their life. And there's only one thing that could take place that'd be greater in this room tonight, and that is for you to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ and for eternity to be settled. They would be honored if you would do so. If you don't know the Lord tonight, may you be reminded tonight that God loves you, that He sent His Son Jesus Christ, and He sacrificed Himself, and He humbled Himself to become what you, He became what you need, a Savior. And you can go to heaven. You can have your sins forgiven through the Lord Jesus Christ. You can call upon Him. You can trust Him. You can receive Him. And you can become one with Him and one with God. What a union. What a communion in the Lord Jesus Christ. Caleb, Julie, I can't wait to see what God does with you. Amazing things. You love one another. Remember that triangle that we drew that very first time we met and we talked? You two can come together tonight and leave God out of it. And you might find some measure of happiness. But the greatest happiness will be when you seek God and love Him with all of your heart. And when you seek God and love Him with all of your heart, and when the both of you have the Lord number one in your life, then you will be the closest that you'll ever be, at the very top, there with God, being honored and glorified through your lives. We love you. We want what's best for you. And we're privileged to be here at this time.
Appreciate the message on the love of God. It's incredible that God would love us, that He would have anything to do with us. My mind at weddings goes to Romans chapter 8 because it describes the love that He just presented. That you're to, when He read there in Ephesians, that you're to love for like Christ loves the church. But we read about that love. Let me read it, and then we'll do the vows. The Bible says here in Romans chapter 8, verse 35, it says, "Whoso separate us from the love of Christ." Now, I want you to put yourself in that position, because you're going to love her like Christ loved the church. Who shall separate her from your love? He said, "Shall tribulation, shall distress, shall persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Now listen to this. He says, for I am persuaded. Talking about Paul saying, you know what he says. Yeah, I'm persuaded that God, nothing's going to separate us from God. But take that same and make that same vow together here. That nothing shall be able to separate us from the love of God. He says, for I'm persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. So we take these vows. This is forever. You know that. We talked about it. Would you join hands there, please? Caleb, repeat after me. Look at her, okay? Say, I, Caleb, take thee.
I, Caleb, take thee.
Juliana.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward,
to live together
after God's ordinance
in holy matrimony,
to comfort you,
to love you,
to honor you,
and keep you
for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in days of darkness
and in days of brightness,
in sickness
and in health.
Forsaking all others,
keeping myself
only unto you,
till death do us part.
Juliana, repeat after me.
Say,
I, Juliana,
take thee,
Caleb,
to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
to live together,
after God's ordinance,
in holy matrimony,
to comfort you,
and love you,
and honor you,
and keep you,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
in days of darkness,
and in the days of brightness,
in sickness and in health,
forsaking all others,
keeping myself
only unto you,
until death do us part.
I have her ring.
Slide that ring for me. Just hold it there.
As a token of this covenant that you're making with God today and with each other, you're going to receive these rings. These rings, as we see, as a ring is an unbroken circle. It's the emblem of eternity. It's from now until Jesus comes. And the untarnished gold represents the enduring and lasting pledge that you're going to make with each other. So, Caleb, repeat after me. Juliana,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
With this ring,
I seal my vows.
All my earthly possessions.
And all my spiritual blessings,
I endow to thee.
Very good.
Juliana, repeat after me. Caleb,
with this ring I thee wed.
With this ring,
I seal my vows.
With all my earthly possessions.
And spiritual blessings.
I endow to thee.
You put it.
Very good. Thank you.
You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Caleb Stallman.
Again, thank you so much for being here this evening. This means so much to this young couple. The fact that you were here, they might not get to talk to each and every one of you if you do not come to the reception. They would ask a few things. Number one, if you would remain seated until you are dismissed. The ushers will begin to dismiss from the back. And then please join us at the reception. It is at another property. When you go back out to Highway 53, where Casey's service station is, if you will turn left, go north on 53, about a mile out of town, you'll cross a hill just to the, on the, as you're going down the hill to the left is Highway DD. And turn left on Highway DD, first driveway on the left. Follow the stream of taillights headed that direction, okay? Please come. If you come there, you will be able to talk to the bride and groom. They will come to each table and greet you personally. They want to see you. They want to talk to you. And that will be your opportunity to do so. Family, please, all family, aunts, uncles, cousins, they said every bit of the family, please stay behind. Just remain seated. They're going to do three or four pictures, and then they'll be there promptly, okay? Most of their pictures have been taken, and they'll be at the reception promptly. Thank you again for being here. Let's pray. We'll be dismissed with a word of prayer. We'll ask the Lord to bless the food, and that will be taken care of. And thank you again for your attendance. Father, it is truly a blessing to see a young couple who have you in their heart and life. Lord, they have done this the right way, and I thank you for them. I pray that you would bless them as they honor you. Lord, you use their lives and help them as they serve one another, as they serve others, and as they serve you. May their lives be fruitful lives. May eternity be affected and changed because of this union here tonight. If there's one here who doesn't know the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior, that'd be the greatest thing that would take place on this day. Lord, if they're uncertain of that and want to know more, they can talk to me or to Brother Smith, one of these family members here, a mom or dad. Lord, we'd sure love to talk to them about Jesus Christ, get them pointed toward Him. Help us as we travel to the reception. Bless the food there. Thank you for that you have provided for us. Nourish our bodies with it. We pray for the many miles to be traveled. Some will be headed home tonight. Give them traveling mercy and safety. Lord, those tomorrow traveling, give them the same. Thank you again for this time, for your help and strength. May Jesus Christ be uplifted and may God be glorified, and we'll thank you for it. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.